Welcome to the complete FPS optimization guide for VRising on your PC and laptop. This should be quite an easy tutorial. For more information, click on the first link in the description below. We will first take a look at your in-game settings before making changes to your operating system. Open up VRising and navigate to your graphics options. Here, you can first of all choose a quality preset. When using a low to mid-end PC, then make sure to set it to medium for now. All of the next settings will be set for low-end PC, which doesn't have a lot of resources to spare. If you're using a higher-end CPU and GPU, then feel free to increase some of the next setting suggestions. Set the screen resolution to your native monitor resolution. In my case, that would be 3440 by 1440. To get the best performance, make sure to play in full screen mode. The brightness option below will not affect your performance, so set this to your personal preference. In your quality settings, set the ambient occlusion option to low, bloom to medium, shadow to low, as well as volumetric quality. I prefer to set the shadows to a minimum, but you might want to increase the setting to medium. In your advanced graphics settings, make sure to completely disable anti-aliasing. This can make your game look a bit more laggy when playing VRising on a lower screen refresh rate. Set the AMD FSR option to performance and disable vertical sync. I prefer to disable motion blur, but this will come down to personal preference. Leave depth of field enabled, disable high quality vegetation, as well as low quality atmosphere. Lastly, I prefer to lower the screen shake option to 50% and set the cloth quality and cloth update rate to medium. These two last settings can have a lot of impact on your graphics card's performance. In case you notice any lag, then make sure to lower the cloth quality setting to low first. After applying your changes, leave the game running and open up your task manager. From here, right-click the VRising process and select to go to details. The main game process should be highlighted in this list. Simply right-click the process and set the priority to high. In order to reduce the CPU utilization from other programs, I suggest you end some programs from running in the background, which you don't need when playing the game. But make sure to only end programs from running which you know won't break your operating system. In the Startup tab, you can additionally prevent programs from starting up on system boot. You can then close VRising and your task manager. You should make sure that your graphics card driver is up to date. I suggest using the GeForce Experience application if you're using an NVIDIA GPU, but you can also use the AMD Radeon software. In the Drivers tab, simply click on Download, and the application will automatically download and install the latest driver. Repeat this step at least a few times a year to make sure that you get the most out of your hardware. When navigating to your GeForce settings, make sure to disable the in-game overlay in your General Settings tab, as application overlays often cause performance issues. Below, you have the option to enable the image scaling option. For some of you, this option is not available as your graphics driver is not up to date. Enabling NVIDIA image scaling can dramatically increase your frame rate for any game you play on your PC. After making sure that your GPU driver is up to date, open up your system settings window. Here, navigate to the gaming section. Under game mode, you have the option to enable or disable game mode on your PC. In theory, game mode should prevent Windows Update from performing driver installations and sending restart notifications, as well as help achieve a more stable frame rate while in game. In your related settings, select Graphics. Click on Browse to change some custom graphics settings for VRising. In your File Explorer, navigate to the drive on which you saved the game on. The file path for the Steam version is Program Files, Steam, Steam Apps, Common, VRising, and here select the VRising EXE application. This will add the VRising application to this list below. When selecting options for the game, Make sure to set the graphics preference to high performance, which in most cases will take advantage of your graphics processor to help run the game on your system. Keep your settings window open and search for update to get to your Windows Update settings. Make sure to check for recent updates, and in case there is an update available to you, make sure to download it before restarting your PC, which will install the update for you. In case you have any further issues or problems following this tutorial, then I suggest following my extensive guide linked in the description below. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions, and see you in the next one.